feet are pretty. Romans 10:15 says, how beautiful are the feet of those who preach the gospel of peace and bring glad tidings of good things. Satan wants a different gospel preached, so there won't be any power. And if there's no power, then he can continue to wreak havoc in our lives. But Jesus said that he has given us power to tread on serpents and scorpions and over all the works of the enemy. If you know the Savior, have the Spirit, and know the story, you won't be a victim of spiritual identity theft. I used to work in banking, and all my brothers and sisters, whenever they hired new tellers, they would have to be trained on how to recognize counterfeit money. This was before the counterfeit pens were available. And the bank didn't expose the tellers to counterfeit bills to train them, but they exposed them to real money. Because the idea was that if they became so familiar with the real thing, they would spot a counterfeit a mile away. And that's how we need to be. We need to be so familiar with the real thing that when they preach another Jesus, present another spirit, and proclaim another story, we can spot it a mile away and tell them, like the songwriter said, you can't make me doubt it. Because I know too much about it. I'm reminded of a story of a man who was on the side of the road with a bird cage. And a boy noticed that the cage was full of birds of many kinds. Where did you get those birds from? He asked. All over the place, the man replied. I lure them with crumbs and pretend I'm their friend. Then when they're close, I net them and shove them into my cage. And what are you going to do with them now that you have them in your cage? The man grinned and said, I'm going to prod them with sticks and get them really mad so they fight and kill each other. My brothers and sisters, and those that survive, I kill myself. None of these birds will escape. And the little boy looked steadily at the man. What made him do such things? He looked into the cruel, hard eyes, and the boy looked at the birds, defenseless and without hope in the cave. Can I buy those birds from you? The boy asked. The man hid a smile of whether he could be on to a good thing if he played his cards right. So the man says, well, the cage is pretty expensive, and I spent a lot of time collecting these birds. I tell you what I'll do. I'll let you have a lot, the whole lot, the birds, cage and all, for £10 and the jacket on your back. The boy paused for a moment and thought about it. £10 was all he had, and the jacket was new and very special to him. In fact, it was his prized possession. Slowly, he took out the £10 and handed over his jacket. And then even more slowly, he gave it to the man. And all my brothers and sisters, he opened the door of the cage and let the birds go flee. The enemy of the world, Satan, was on the side of the road with a very large cage. The man was coming towards him, noticed that it was crammed full of people of every kind, young and old, from every race and nation. Where did you get those people from? The man asked. From all over the world, Satan replied. I lure them in with drink, drugs, lust and lies, anger, hate, love of money, and all manner of things, and I pretend I'm their friend. I have to give them a good time, and when I've hooked them, I lure them in my cage. And what are you going to do with them now that you got them in your cage? The man asked. Satan grinned and said, I'm going to prod them and provoke them, get them to hate and destroy each other. I'll stir up racial hatred, defiance of law and order. I'll make people bored, lonely, dissatisfied, and confused. It's easy because people always listen to what I offer, and what's better, they blame God for the results. But the man asked, now, if you're going to destroy the people, then why don't you let me buy the people? And Satan snarled and said, yeah, you can buy the people, but it's going to cost you your life. And so Jesus Christ, the Son of God, paid for our release from freedom from Satan's trap with his life on Calvary's hill. He walked the hill called Calvary till it hung on a rugged cross. There where he died for our sin. That way he died for the sins of the world. My brothers and sisters, they laid him in a borrowed tomb. And he laid there all night Friday. He laid there all night Saturday. But early Sunday morning, he got up with all power in his hand. Do you know he's real? Is Jesus real to you? Does he walk with you? Does he talk with you? Does he tell you you are his own? Is he good?